Hello everyone, Sunday morning, and I'm about to go fly my hawk, but she's a little heavier than I wanted, so I thought I would wait a little bit and do a quick drawing while I wait for her to drop some weight. I want to thank Marker Universe for sending me art supplies, mostly Kuretake and these new amazing Zig alcohol-based markers that I'm loving a lot. So let's get started. I usually like to do my layout with a blender, but sometimes, and this is the blender, it's not a color, it just blends the marker tones together. But it depends on your paper. Sometimes it'll take, and other times, if it's darker paper, it'll just keep evaporating. So I'm gonna go with a lighter gray. I'm gonna go with the bigger chisel tip here. So I do have reference in front of me that I'm looking at, so I'm not popping this out of my head. I do that as well, but sometimes you need those lessons. I do have also a reference of here's my Christmas gift to myself. It's a jaguar, male jaguar skull that I ordered from Bone Clones. So I have it right next to my desk to look at some landmarks. As you go through your journey as an artist, you start developing some techniques that work for you and start developing sort of your arsenal of what you're going to be using when you sketch. One thing that I learned from Andrew Loomis from the books is the use of landmarks, and he uses them for anatomy, and I like to use them to measure my distances between things. I hope everyone had a great holiday season, and we still have New Year's, and hopefully our next New Year will be a little better than what originally has happened. I gotta speed myself up a little bit because I want this to be a loose sketch, not something that I'm... So I'm gonna speed things up a little bit. Sometimes when I speed up, it causes some amazing accidents that wouldn't happen because I'm overanalyzing. So that's another great thing. Sometimes loose sketches are the ones that people enjoy the most. I'm excited to start a project that I'll be doing this year on cats. Wild cats. Not feral cats. So I think that's enough info for us to go, for me to go by. I am planning to do a trip to the Pantanal soon. Take my own photography, and I want to see these beautiful animals in their environment. So I was very close. Not very close, but I have a friend that his project was very close to his heart, and that was jaguars and saving them. So you go. There's my quick layout. I'm gonna go in now and do some line work with it. I'm using the Kuretake brush pen here. I'm gonna keep this loose as well. letting the brush do its accidents and try not to overanalyze as well and let my hand and my eye work together. This is a huge, significant difference between a female and a male jag. It took me a bit to figure it out, but there is. It's quite a huge difference in the head size. And one way to distinguish that is look at their eye size. So relatively, their eyes are usually about the same size, male and a female. But if you look at the male size of the eyes related to its head, you'll see how much of a difference they are. The eyes almost get lost in such huge space. And that would be a full-grown adult jaguar. I'm loving these brushes. And I've had really good luck with them being water-resistant. Some of the Kuretake aren't, but I think it says in the packaging. All the ones that Marker Universe has sent, for the most part, have been. Now, I use landmarks to guide me. Like, I just look to see where the spots would start relatively to the nose. So I'm going to do an in-depth stream on this soon. That's one of my plans for this year is, and I know Aaron Blaze has encouraged me. I just always figure that you have people like Aaron teaching and they're so good, you know, but I guess there's different ways to view things, and Tara Whitlatch would show you one way, I would show you a different way, Ian McKeag would show a different, so. Still, I'm happy with what I have so far. No bad goof-ups yet. Of course, what takes a lot of time in doing jags is the fur work. I find it a bit meditative, but it can get monotonous. But you can't just go in there and just put spots. The spots actually give you a lot of information as to what which way the contour of the body goes. So I haven't gotten to go out yet to trap or locate any mountain lions. I'm looking forward to it. We haven't had as much snow as we needed. Well, as is needed, but my friends have already started doing their biology work with them. He's a big boy. All right. Settle that down. Let's start putting our spots down. I may fast forward this spot. I'm going to put a little bit of detail with this sign pen here. Just a little thinner brush point. And give me the sense of some fur. I don't want much, just a little bit, just indications here and there. Going to use some gouache, throw a little bit of color on this guy. The paper, the tone of the paper always already gives it some tone, so just put in a little bit of saturation in some of the areas that I want. Not too much. I'm gonna put some yellow down as well. I don't want it too powerful. I just want it enough in there. There. Just letting some of those accidents happen on their own. More diluted out here. See how it dries and see how it looks. I may go thicker on some with the yellow in some areas. Just to see, just kind of like that. Oh, is it gonna dissipate? Maybe it'll dissipate, I'm not sure. Let's see. See if that'll work. I'm just having fun and experimenting. I'm not sweating anything. Stand out a little bit more using the thicker gouache. I've lost some of the spots, so I may have to retouch some of those. I'm already at 20 minutes. I wanted it to be a 30-minute deal. So let's see if we can finish. Give me a better sense after I dried to see where it was gonna not be as strong. So, the color I'm talking about. I may go a little denser there with the gouache. To make him stick out a little more in here. Bring some attention to his face. Not that he's beautiful enough not to have the attention already, but this will dissipate. Give us some equal treatment on the other side. I'm dabbing the gouache just in areas. Maybe that'll work. Let's dry it. Using a Derwent color pencil to pop him out a little bit on some of the areas that I want lighter. I'm working around the spots, which is probably the wrong thing to do. It probably would have been easier for me to get all my lights and darks and then go over, but I'm just having fun and making some use of some of my time that I have here waiting for my hawk to drop a little bit of weight before I go out with her. She's like a fighter, she has to make weight. And there's a huge window that we work off of, but I just feel yesterday was a little heavier than what I wanted, and I probably fed her more than what we were still successful in the hunt yesterday, but probably fed her more than what I should have. I didn't want to go. I thought she would drop more last night than what we did, what she did. We still caught. She still hunted, but just some little minute changes that I see that you get to learn to read when you've been flying birds of prey for so long. So this isn't a white pencil, it's wheat color, just off of a, I don't want it straight white, I want my whites to pop out more, so I've switched. So I still think he needs some color in here, so I'm gonna drop some color in there. I'm gonna go with the burnt sienna though, not the yellow. Just to put in some shadows in here, this back area. I feel that I went so strong on some of those yellows that I almost need to put some in here just to equalize things. Beautiful music you're here in the background is from a friend of mine named David Arkenstone, who I use a lot of his music in my videos. And this is a rainforest one. Sometimes I use ambient sounds to inspire me, kind of transport me to wherever I'm, my mindset should be at, and in this case, it's the rainforest of either Brazil or Mexico. Mixed media piece. For sure. I do have a white in this Derwent, but I wanted to not go as white because I want to use the white to kind of punch a little bit more than. So you try to stay as away from as white as you can. Bear down on some of the areas that are where you want the white to go. I don't know if a lot of you knew, and I probably have said this in the past, but the jaguar is the only cat that doesn't go for the throat when it kills. It goes for the back of the head. It's the strongest jaws in the cat family. Big cats. Find the prey usually pierced at the base of the neck. Forgot my spots here for some reason. Cutting on my time limit here. Shine to some of these areas. I think that'll work. I'm going with some white now. I don't know if the white's gonna punch through the way I want it to. I may have to go to gouache. Seems to be working. I want it to be brighter than what the tone is, but then dissipate in some of the areas. So I vary my pressure as I want where I want the brightest and the lightest, you know. I'm gonna have to go in with some paint just to do a couple of punctures. Sometimes I use this fluid, this correction fluid for my finals. I did get this amazing white brush. And that I'll try, it's called a Zig Cartoonist. So it says on the, and it's all white. It's got a little clicker on the back to force the paint to come through. So I may use that to highlight him here in a minute. Once I get these whites where I want them. I may have got too yellow in some of these areas, but it's fine. It's all in fun, it's all no pressure. I do need to go in and put some, darken some of these blacks in that got lost, so. This is the whitest, most cooperative pencil that I've found, is this Derwent. Prismacolor is good too, but I just like the covering power of this thing. It seems to do the job. As you can see, here's a white Prismacolor. It's gonna prove me wrong here. I do keep them both though. Let's see. I'm gonna bear down on this guy, and it seems to be doing good. Take that back, Prismacolor. Pretty white. You make use with tools that you have. There's really no better tool than another. You have to experiment. Some people like some things, other people like other things, so. I tend to squint a lot when I'm looking at my drawing to see where I need tones and colors. Something that we, it's a little tool that you have that a lot of people don't use. Where's my white? There's my white pen. Let's try this out. It's nice. Just hit some of the areas that I need white on. Maybe I need to click it more. There we go. And it is a waxy base that's underneath, so that could struggle. That could make the brush struggle a bit to get the pigment to grab on. I don't want to get too white here, just show some indications of some areas that I need. There we go. You guys can go on markeruniverse.com and use MANu20, and you will get a discount, a 20% discount, I believe. If you're interested in any of these supplies that I'm using, they have a whole array of different amazing stuff, so. I'm really liking this. This is nice. This is a really nice pen. Or brush, I should say. Look at that. I just need to get it going. Wow. It really punches through. I just needed to get the ink to run through, that's all. I don't know if it's thin enough for me to do the whiskers. So I always use a white pen to do that with. I think it's getting a little murky here. I think the watercolor's blending in. Oh, there we go, guys. I think that's enough. I think I went past my time that I wanted to do. I need to go eat myself. Hope every one of you has a great holiday season, and let's hope for a better next year. I'm looking for my white. There we go. I like using these Uniball Signos. They're really nice. So, put some whiskers on this guy. A lot of you know how they know me really well. Sometimes I have some cat drawings out there that I forget to put whiskers on. Oh yeah, the eyes. I need to put some color in those eyes. Some color in those eyes. Let's see. I don't know what I did with my watercolor set. For the most part, I hope you guys enjoyed. Time to go fly the hawk and see how she does. One more thing, I need to put a little more contrast on this. Gonna put a little bit of foliage back here. Being in the jungle, sense of some ambience, environmental plant and foliage here. Let's put a little bit of color here. And then we'll call it done. Just some greens and some yellows and couple of greens to give a sense of jungle. I'm not being very careful, just jotting some colors down. Let's dab some yellow on some of these leaves. It's always nice to see how the paint dries or soaks into the paper that I'm using. This paper's usually pretty good about keeping the colors. Kind of camouflages in right in.